Okay, our next band is Ready. They are the Osceola County School for the Arts Jazz A. And they come from Kissimmee, Florida. And their band director is Mr. Jason Anderson. Give him a big welcome.
Thank you. Ellington on the trumpet. Solomon Galette on the alto sax. Kiara Rouse on the tenor saxophone. And Daniel Brown on the trombone. Thank you so much. It's wonderful to be back in the house to swing again. Thank you so much to everyone here at Jazz at Lincoln Center and our esteemed judges for making all of this possible. Of course, we'd like to thank our community and all the teachers and admin at our school, as well as our superintendent Shanoff and our school board for supporting this band and these students all year long. We're going to continue now with the Duke Ellington composition entitled The Giddy Bug Gallop. Again, Daniel Brown on trombone. Solomon Galette on the alto saxophone. And Luis Fernandez Guzman on clarinet. Okay, we're gonna slow it down now and play some blues for our final selection. Our soloist will be Juan Alvarado on the piano, Luis Fernandez Guzman on clarinet again, and Xavier Anderson on the trumpet. This is Blues to Be There.
And we're back here live from the House of Swing, Jazz Elegant Center here in New York City. Wow. Osceola County School for the Arts are here. Their director, Jason Anderson, just came off the stage, burning it up. Let's talk a little bit about what's in the water in Kissimmee, Florida.
Well, I don't know. These kids work hard. They must be drinking something good, so, you know.
And this is your third year there?
Third year, yes.
And you inherited a program that had done pretty well and had been here before. Our good friend Edwin Santiago was the director before. Talk a little bit about what you've done to continue that legacy and build on, you know, just you've won 2 years in a row. You have this outstanding program. Where do the kids keep coming from?
Well, I guess it's, you know, a lot of it is word of mouth. But, you know, like you said, it was a good program. And then they went through some turmoil. And then when I stepped in, it was kind of after COVID and it was tough. But the kids were still hungry. There's not a lot down there for them, you know, so it's kind of like when they find something that they love, they just put everything into it, so.
And you're an art school, right?
Yes, 6 through 12, and they can start taking jazz in 7th grade.
Oh, that's great. So, and you've got your eyes on all of that. Are you actually teaching the middle school jazz band?
I teach 4 bands, A, B, C, and Jazz Lab.
That's awesome. That's great. Okay, let's talk about your programming a little bit. First of all, you're one of the few bands this year that played that really up-tempo tune, Giddy Bug. Actually, the judges were asking about it. How do you teach holding a rhythm like that? I mean, you're talking quarter note at almost 300. I mean, it's really fast.
360.
Yeah, when you were counting off, when he counted off, you were counting off bars at the beginning, and that was 4 beats to a bar. What's your strategy for teaching how to hold a rhythm together like that?
Well, it's all about that swing at any tempo, I feel like. And so I had to just try to make the beat bigger for them so that they could really kind of just settle into it and feel that swing. They could feel it so it wouldn't sound so frantic and more laid back. So that was a big thing. We practiced counting it off in different ways, and that was the one that kind of worked the best. So funny, interesting story. The chart came out after Thanksgiving break, and like during it. And when we came back, they already knew the parts.
How did that happen?
They just got in the shed and learned how to play.
Got in the shed and learned how to play, folks. That's the answer. Let's get a couple of your kids in here. Come on in here. All right. And give us your name and what year you are in school. Let's start with you, Solomon. I know you.
My name is Solomon Galetta, and I'm a senior.
And you?
My name is Xavier Anderson, and I'm a freshman.
So I know Solomon because he was a student at our Summer Jazz Academy. Solomon, you've been here before. You've played on the stage. I believe this is your third time, right? Talk a little bit about what that means to you as a senior.
Well, as a senior, it really means a lot, especially coming my third year because, I mean, of course, when you first come here, you feel really small and this whole place feels big and you don't know what to do with it. But the more you come, the more you learn how special it is. And I think it's great that I get to come multiple times and share the culture with kids younger than me and, like, show them, like, the power of, you know, the House of Swing.
And Xavier, you were here last year as an 8th grader. I remember you coming here. You traded, you played solos and traded 4s on Perdido. Yeah. And now you're here, and you had a feature on Night Tunisia, and then, you know, went and played there at the end on Blues to be there. And I think you're playing lead, right?
Yeah, I am.
So, okay, so talk about this experience. Now, you're in 9th grade, folks. This is a 9th grader I'm talking to here. Talk a little bit about what it's like and to be in a band with folks like Solomon who are seniors. You're in 9th grade. What's the future hold for you?
I mean, everything. I feel like I have so much to learn from everybody in the band, like especially all the seniors. They've taught me so much about like living life and college and music and playing, and I feel like especially through this festival I'm able to connect with so many people too, and I feel like I'm able to learn from everybody.
That's great. And Solomon, what are you doing next year?
Next year I'll be attending Yale University.
The Yale University?
The Yale University, yes.
And we still keep playing? What's your major going to be?
Of course. I'm going to be a global affairs major, but I plan to join the jazz collective over there, so I'm excited.
That's awesome. And, of course, as a 9th grader, you're just going to be in high school again next year, right? Yeah. Who knows? Maybe we'll see you back here. Yeah. So, anyway, folks, Osceola County School for the Arts just finished their performance. Up next, the last band of the first part of our section, our first section here, for the 29th annual Essentially Ellington Festival. Up next, Byron Center High School from Byron Center, Michigan. Stay with us. We'll be right back. Check out the QR code and support Jazz Elegant Center. We'll be right back.